Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This is Salim bin Mohammed Raffi, your host. I am very grateful that I am sharing with you the Prophet of Islam, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who introduced me and all mankind to my and your Creator, and of course the Creator of the whole world, Allah Almighty Subhan wa Ta'ala. As all followers of Islam like to address the Creator, this is the name Allah Subhan chosen for by Allah Himself. Muhammad, peace be upon him, introduced Allah Subhan to whole mankind. We offer our salutations to him every moment and opportunity we get. We Muslims call those salutations as Durudo Salam, which you will listen now in the beginning in Arabic.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan-nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin bi'adad man salla wa sama wa salli kathalik wa salli kathalik ala jami'il anbiya'i wal mursaleen wa ala al malaikatil muqarrabin وعلى عباد الله الصالحين وعلى صاحب الحياء وناشر القرآن الشهيد المظلوم حين تلاوة الفرقان عثمان بن عفان رضي الله تعالى عنه.
As the Holy Prophet arranged himself in his lifetime, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu asked Hazrat Usman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, now that contribution of the caliph or companions of our Prophet, both Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who was asked by the Prophet to do this, and he in turn asked Hazrat Usman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu to carry out that task. So we are indebted with gratitude and acknowledge their contribution, because all of us are reading, reciting the same book, the same Quran. So this contribution of these companions of the Prophet will be till the end of the times. We are most grateful.
Sixth para. The sixth para or juz of the Quran is La Yu'abula, which has two surahs. The first one is Surah An-Nisa 4, ayat 148 to 176. Second is Surah Al-Maidah 5, ayat 1 to 82. Total no of ayat in this para, 111.
Allah loves not that evil should be noised abroad in public speech, except where injustice has been done. For Allah is He who hears and knows all things. Whether you publish a good deed or conceal it, or cover evil with pardon, verily, Allah does blot out sins, and has power in the judgment of values. Those who deny Allah and His messengers, and those who wish to separate Allah from His messengers, saying, "We believe in some but reject others," and those who wish to take a course midway, they are in truth equally unbelievers. And we have prepared for unbelievers a humiliating punishment. To those who believe in Allah and His messengers and make no distinction between any of the messengers, we shall soon give their due rewards, for Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. The people of the book ask you to cause a book to descend to them from heaven. Indeed, they asked Moses for an even greater miracle, for they said, "Show us Allah in public." But they were dazed for their presumption by thunder and lightning. Yet they worshipped the calf even after clear signs had come to them. Even so we forgave them, and gave Moses manifest proofs of authority. And for their covenant we raised over them the towering height of Mount Sinai. And on another occasion we said, "Enter the gate with humility." And once again we commanded them, "Transgress not in the matter of the Sabbath." And we took from them a solemn covenant. They have incurred divine displeasure in that they broke their covenant, that they rejected the signs of Allah, that they slew the messengers in defiance of right, that they said, "Our hearts are the wrappings which preserve Allah's word, we need no more." Nay, Allah has set the seal on their hearts for their blasphemy, and little is it that they believe, that they rejected faith, that they uttered against Mary a grave false charge, that they said in boast, "We killed Christ Jesus, the son of Mary, the messenger of Allah," but they killed him not, nor crucified him, but so it was made to appear to them. And those who differ therein are full of doubts, with no certain knowledge, but only conjecture to follow, for of a surety they killed him not. Nay, Allah raised him up unto himself, and Allah is exalted in power, wise. And there is none of the people of the book but must believe in him before his death, and on the day of judgment he will be a witness against them. For the iniquity of the Jews we made unlawful for them, certain foods good and wholesome, which had been lawful for them, in that they hindered many from Allah's way. That they took usury though they were forbidden, and that they devoured men's substance wrongfully, we have prepared for those among them who reject faith a grievous punishment. But those among them who are well grounded in knowledge and the believers believe in what has been revealed to you and what was revealed before you, and especially those who establish regular prayer and practice regular charity and believe in Allah and in the last day, to them shall we soon give a great reward. We have sent you inspiration as we sent it to Noah and the messengers after him. We sent inspiration to Abram, Ismail, Isaac, Jacob and the descendants, to Jesus, Job, Jonah, Aaron and Solomon, and to David we gave the Psalms. Of some messengers we have already told you the story, of others we have not, and to Moses Allah spoke direct. Messengers who gave good news as well as warning, that mankind, after the coming of the messengers, should have no plea against Allah, for Allah is exalted in power, wise. But Allah bears witness that what He has sent unto you, He has sent from His own knowledge, and the angels bear witness, but enough is Allah for a witness. Those who reject faith and keep off men from the way of Allah have verily strayed far, far away from the path. Those who reject faith and do wrong, Allah will not forgive them, nor guide them to any way, except the way of hell, to dwell therein forever, and this to Allah is easy. O mankind, the messenger has come to you in truth from Allah. Believe in him, it is best for you. But if you reject faith, to Allah belong all things in the heavens and on earth, and Allah is all-knowing, all-wise. O people of the book, commit no excesses in your religion, nor say of Allah aught but the truth. Christ Jesus, the son of Mary, was no more than a messenger of Allah, and his word, which he bestowed on Mary and a spirit proceeding from him, so believe in Allah and his messengers. Say not Trinity, desist, it will be better for you, for Allah is one God, glory be to Him, far exalted is He above having a son. To Him belong all things in the heavens and on earth, and enough is Allah, as a disposer of affairs. Christ disdains not to serve and worship Allah, nor do the angels, those nearest to Allah, those who disdain His worship and are arrogant, He will gather them all together unto Himself to answer. But those who believe and do deeds of righteousness, He will give their due rewards, and more out of His bounty. But those who are disdainful and arrogant, He will punish with a grievous penalty. Nor will they find besides Allah any to protect or help them. O mankind, verily there has come to you a convincing proof from your Lord, for we have sent unto you a light that is manifest. Then those who believe in Allah and hold fast to Him, soon will He admit them to mercy and grace from Himself, and guide them to Himself by a straight way. They ask you for a legal decision. Say, Allah directs thus about those who leave no descendants or ascendants as heirs. If it is a man that dies, leaving a sister but no child, she shall have half the inheritance. If such a deceased was a woman who left no child, her brother takes her inheritance. If there are two sisters, they shall have two-thirds of the inheritance between them. If they are brothers and sisters, they share, the male having twice the share of the female. Thus does Allah make clear to you His law, lest you err, and Allah has knowledge of all things.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
O you who believe, fulfill all obligations. Lawful unto you for food are all four-footed animals, with the exceptions named. But animals of the chase are forbidden while you are in the sacred precincts or in pilgrim garb. For Allah does command according to His will and plan. O you who believe, violate not the sanctity of the symbols of Allah, nor of the sacred month, nor of the animals brought for sacrifice, nor the garlands that mark out such animals, nor the people resorting to the sacred house, seeking of the bounty and good pleasure of their Lord. But when you are clear of the sacred precincts and of pilgrim garb, you may hunt, and let not the hatred of some people in once shutting you out of the sacred mosque lead you to transgression and hostility on your part. Help you one another in righteousness and piety, but help you not one another in sin and rancor. Fear Allah, for Allah is strict in punishment. Forbidden to you for food are dead meat, blood, the flesh of swine, and that on which has been invoked the name of other than Allah, that which has been killed by strangling, or by a violent blow, or by a headlong fall, or by being gored to death, that which has been partly eaten by a wild animal, unless you are able to slaughter it in due form, that which is sacrificed on stone altars. Forbidden also is the division of meat by raffling with arrows. That is impiety. This day have those who reject faith given up all hope of your religion. Yet fear them not, but fear me. This day have I perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. But if any is forced by hunger, with no inclination to transgression, Allah is indeed oft forgiving, most merciful. They ask you what is lawful to them as food. Say, lawful unto you are all things good and pure, and what you have taught your trained hunting animals to catch in the manner directed to you by Allah. Eat what they catch for you, but pronounce the name of Allah over it, and fear Allah, for Allah is swift in taking account. This day are all things good and pure made lawful unto you. The food of the people of the book is lawful unto you, and yours is lawful unto them. Lawful unto you in marriage are not only chaste women who are believers, but chaste women among the people of the book, revealed before your time, when you give them their due dowers, and desire chastity, not lewdness, nor secret intrigues. If anyone rejects faith, fruitless is his work, and in the hereafter he will be in the ranks of those who have lost all spiritual good. O you who believe, when you prepare for prayer, wash your faces and your hands, and arms to the elbows, rub your heads with water, and wash your feet to the ankles. If you are in a state of ceremonial impurity, bathe your whole body. But if you are ill, or on a journey, or one of you comes from offices of nature, or you have been in contact with women, and you find no water, then take for yourselves clean sand or earth, and rub therewith your faces and hands. Allah does not wish to place you in a difficulty, but to make you clean, and to complete His favor to you, that you may be grateful. And call in remembrance the favor of Allah unto you, and His covenant, which He ratified with you when you said, "We hear and we obey." And fear Allah, for Allah knows well the secrets of your hearts. O you who believe, stand out firmly for Allah, as witnesses to fair dealing, and let not the hatred of others to you make you swerve to wrong and depart from justice. Be just, that is, next to piety, and fear Allah, for Allah is well acquainted with all that you do. To those who believe and do deeds of righteousness, has Allah promised forgiveness and a great reward. Those who reject faith and deny our signs will be companions of hellfire. O you who believe, call in remembrance the favor of Allah unto you when certain men formed the design to stretch out their hands against you, but Allah held back their hands from you. So fear Allah, and on Allah let believers put all their trust. Allah did aforetime take a covenant from the children of Israel, and we appointed 12 captains among them. And Allah said, "I am with you, if you but establish regular prayers, practice regular charity, believe in my messengers, honor and assist them, and loan to Allah a beautiful loan. Verily, I will wipe out from you your evils, and admit you to gardens with rivers flowing beneath. But if any of you after this resist faith, he has truly wandered from the path of rectitude." But because of their breach of their covenant, we cursed them, and made their hearts grow hard. They change the words from their right places, and forget a good part of the message that was sent them. Nor will you cease to find them, barring a few, ever bent on new deceits. But forgive them and overlook their misdeeds, for Allah loves those who are kind. From those too who call themselves Christians, we did take a covenant. But they forgot a good part of the message that was sent them. So we estranged them, with enmity and hatred between the one and the other, to the day of judgment, and soon will Allah show them what it is they have done. O people of the book, there has come to you our messenger revealing to you much that you used to hide in the book, and passing over much that is now unnecessary. There has come to you from Allah a new light and a perspicuous book, wherewith Allah guides all who seek His good pleasure to ways of peace and safety, and leads them out of darkness, by His will, unto the light, guides them to a path that is straight. In blasphemy indeed are those that say that Allah is Christ, the Son of Mary. Say, who then has the least power against Allah, if His will were to destroy Christ, the Son of Mary, His mother, and all, everyone, that is on the earth? For to Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and all that is between. He creates what He pleases, for Allah has power over all things. Both the Jews and the Christians say, "We are sons of Allah and His beloved." Say, why then does He punish you for your sins? Nay, you are but men of the men He has created. He forgives whom He pleases, and He punishes whom He pleases. And to Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and all that is between, and unto Him is the final goal of all. O people of the book, now has come unto you, making things clear unto you, our messenger, after the break in the series of our messengers, lest you should say, "There came unto us no bringer of glad tidings, and no warner from evil, but now has come unto you a bringer of glad tidings, and a warner from evil." And Allah has power over all things. Remember, Moses said to his people, "O my people, call in remembrance the favor of Allah unto you, when He produced prophets among you, made you kings, and gave you what He had not given to any other among the peoples. O my people, enter the holy land which Allah has assigned unto you, and turn not back ignominiously, for then will you be overthrown to your own ruin." They said, "O Moses, in this land are a people of exceeding strength. Never shall we enter it until they leave it. If once they leave, then shall we enter." But among their God-fearing men were two on whom Allah had bestowed His grace. They said, assault them at the proper gate. When once you are in, victory will be yours. But on Allah, put your trust if you have faith. They said, O Moses, while they remain there, never shall we be able to enter, to the end of time. Go you and your Lord and fight you two while we sit here and watch. He said, O my Lord, I have power only over myself and my brother, so separate us from this rebellious people. Allah said, therefore will the land be out of their reach for 40 years. In distraction will they wander through the land, but sorrow you not over these rebellious people. Recite to them the truth of the story of the two sons of Adam. Behold, they each presented a sacrifice to Allah. It was accepted from one, but not from the other. Said the latter, be sure, I will slay you. Surely, said the former, Allah does accept of the sacrifice of those who are righteous. If you do stretch your hand against me to slay me, it is not for me to stretch my hand against you to slay you, for I do fear Allah, the cherisher of the worlds. For me, I intend to let you draw on yourself my sin as well as yours, for you will be among the companions of the fire, and that is the reward of those who do wrong. The selfish soul of the other led him to the murder of his brother. He murdered him and became himself one of the lost ones. Then Allah sent a raven who scratched the ground to show him how to hide the shame of his brother. Woe is me, said he. Was I not even able to be as this raven and to hide the shame of my brother? Then he became full of regrets. On that account we ordained for the children of Israel that if anyone slew a person, unless it be for murder or for spreading mischief in the land, it would be as if he slew the whole people. And if anyone saved a life, it would be as if he saved the life of the whole people. Then although there came to them our messengers with clear signs, yet even after that, many of them continued to commit excesses in the land. The punishment of those who wage war against Allah and His Messenger and strive with might and main for mischief through the land is execution or crucifixion, or the cutting off of hands and feet from opposite sides, or exile from the land. That is their disgrace in this world, and a heavy punishment is theirs in the hereafter. Except for those who repent before they fall into your power, in that case know that Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. O you who believe, do your duty to Allah, seek the means of approach unto Him, and strive with might and main in His cause, that you may prosper. As to those who reject faith, if they had everything on earth, and twice repeated, to give as ransom for the penalty of the day of judgment, it would never be accepted of them. Theirs would be a grievous penalty. Their wish will be to get out of the fire, but never will they get out therefrom. Their penalty will be one that endures. As to the thief, male or female, cut off his or her hands, a punishment by way of example from Allah for their crime, and Allah is exalted in power, full of wisdom. But if the thief repents after his crime and amends his conduct, Allah turns to him in forgiveness, for Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. Know you not that to Allah alone belong the dominion of the heavens and the earth? He punishes whom He pleases, and He forgives whom He pleases, and Allah has power over all things. O Messenger, let not those grieve you who race each other into unbelief, whether it be among those who say, we believe with their lips, but whose hearts have no faith, or it be among the Jews, men who will listen to any lie, will listen even to others who have never so much as come to you. They change the words from their right times and places. They say, if you are given this, take it, but if not, beware. If anyone's trial is intended by Allah, you have no authority in the least for him against Allah. For such, it is not Allah's will to purify their hearts. For them there is disgrace in this world, and in the hereafter a heavy punishment. They are fond of listening to falsehood, of devouring anything forbidden. If they do come to you, either judge between them or decline to interfere. If you decline, they cannot hurt you in the least. If you judge, judge in equity between them. For Allah loves those who judge in equity. But why do they come to you for decision, when they have their own law before them? Therein is the plain command of Allah. Yet even after that, they would turn away, for they are not really people of faith. It was we who revealed the law to Moses. Therein was guidance and light. By its standard have been judged the Jews, by the prophets who bowed, as in Islam, to Allah's will, by the rabbis and the doctors of law, for to them was entrusted the protection of Allah's book, and they were witnesses thereto. Therefore fear not men, but fear me, and sell not my signs for a miserable price. If any do fail to judge by the light of what Allah has revealed, they are no better than unbelievers. We ordained therein for them life for life, eye for eye, nose for nose, ear for ear, tooth for tooth, and wounds equal for equal. But if anyone remits the retaliation by way of charity, it is an act of atonement for himself. And if any fail to judge by the light of what Allah has revealed, they are no better than wrongdoers. And in their footsteps we sent Jesus, the son of Mary, confirming the law that had come before him. We sent him the gospel. Therein was guidance and light, and confirmation of the law that had come before him, a guidance and an admonition to those who fear Allah. Let the people of the gospel judge by what Allah has revealed therein. If any do fail to judge by the light of what Allah has revealed, they are no better than those who rebel. To you we sent the scripture in truth, confirming the scripture that came before it, and guarding it in safety. So judge between them by what Allah has revealed, and follow not their vain desires, diverging from the truth that has come to you. To each among you have we prescribed a law and an open way. If Allah had so willed, He would have made you a single people. But His plan is to test you in what He has given you. So strive as in a race in all virtues. The goal of you all is to Allah. It is He that will show you the truth of the matters in which you dispute. And this He commands, judge you between them by what Allah has revealed, and follow not their vain desires, but beware of them lest they beguile you from any of that teaching which Allah has sent down to you. And if they turn away, be assured that for some of their crimes it is Allah's purpose to punish them, and truly most men are rebellious. Do they then seek after judgment of the days of ignorance? But who, for a people whose faith is assured, can give better judgment than Allah? O you who believe, take not the Jews and the Christians for your friends and protectors. They are but friends and protectors to each other, and he amongst you that turns to them for friendship is of them. Verily, Allah guides not a people unjust. Those in whose hearts is a disease, you see how eagerly they run about among them, saying, we do fear lest a change of fortune bring us disaster. Ah, perhaps Allah will give you victory or a decision according to His will. Then will they repent of the thoughts which they secretly harbored in their hearts. And those who believe will say, are these the men who swore their strongest oaths by Allah, that they were with you? All that they do will be in vain, and they will fall into nothing but ruin. O you who believe, if any from among you turn back from his faith, soon will Allah produce a people whom he will love as they will love him, lowly with the believers, mighty against the rejectors, fighting in the way of Allah, and never afraid of the reproaches of such as find fault. That is the grace of Allah, which he will bestow on whom he pleases, and Allah encompasses all, and he knows all things. Your real friends are no less than Allah, His Messenger, and the fellowship of believers, those who establish regular prayers and regular charity, and they bow down humbly in worship. As to those who turn for friendship to Allah, His Messenger, and the fellowship of believers, it is the fellowship of Allah that must certainly triumph. O you who believe, take not for friends and protectors those who take your religion for a mockery or sport, whether among those who receive the scripture before you or among those who reject faith. But fear you Allah if you have faith indeed. When you proclaim your call to prayer, they take it but as mockery and sport. That is because they are a people without understanding. Say, O people of the book, do you disapprove of us for no other reason than that we believe in Allah and the revelation that has come to us and that which came before us, and perhaps that most of you are rebellious and disobedient? Say, shall I point out to you something much worse than this, as judged by the treatment it received from Allah? Those who incurred the curse of Allah and His wrath, those of whom some He transformed into apes and swine, those who worshipped evil, these are many times worse in rank and far more astray from the even path. When they come to you, they say, we believe, but in fact they enter with a mind against faith, and they go out with the same. But Allah knows fully all that they hide. Many of them do you see racing each other in sin and transgression, and their eatings of things forbidden. Evil indeed are the things that they do. Why do not the rabbis and the doctors of law forbid them from their habit of uttering sinful words and eating things forbidden? Evil indeed are their works. The Jews say, Allah's hand is tied up. Be their hands tied up, and be they accursed, for the blasphemy they utter. Nay, both His hands are widely outstretched. He gives and spends of His bounty as He pleases. But the revelation that comes to you from Allah increases in most of them their obstinate rebellion and blasphemy. Amongst them we have placed enmity and hatred till the day of judgment. Every time they kindle the fire of war, Allah does extinguish it. But they ever strive to do mischief on earth, and Allah loves not those who do mischief. If only the people of the book had believed and been righteous, we should indeed have blotted out their iniquities and admitted them to gardens of bliss. If only they had stood fast by the law, the gospel, and all the revelation that was sent to them from their Lord, they would have enjoyed happiness from every side. There is from among them a party on the right course, but many of them follow a course that is evil. O Messenger, proclaim the message which has been sent to you from your Lord. If you did not, you would not have fulfilled and proclaimed His mission, and Allah will defend you from men who mean mischief. For Allah guides not those who reject faith. Say, O people of the book, you have no ground to stand upon unless you stand fast by the law, the gospel, and all the revelation that has come to you from your Lord. It is the revelation that comes to you from your Lord that increases in most of them their obstinate rebellion and blasphemy. But sorrow you not over these people without faith. Those who believe in the Quran, those who follow the Jewish scriptures, and the Sabians and the Christians, any who believe in Allah and the last day, and who work righteousness, on them shall be no fear, nor shall they grieve. We took the covenant of the children of Israel and sent them messengers. Every time there came to them a messenger with what they themselves desired not, some of these they called impostors, and some they go so far as to slay. They thought there would be no trial or punishment, so they became blind and deaf. Yet Allah in mercy turned to them, yet again many of them became blind and deaf. But Allah sees well all that they do. They do blaspheme who say Allah is Christ, the Son of Mary. But said Christ, O children of Israel, worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord. Whoever joins other gods with Allah, Allah will forbid him the garden, and the fire will be his abode. There will for the wrongdoers be no one to help. They do blaspheme who say, Allah is one of three in a trinity, for there is no God except one God. If they desist not from their word of blasphemy, verily a grievous penalty will befall the blasphemers among them. Why turn they not to Allah and seek His forgiveness? For Allah is oft forgiving, most merciful. Christ, the Son of Mary, was no more than a messenger. Many were the messengers that passed away before Him. His mother was a woman of truth. They had both to eat their daily food. See how Allah does make His signs clear to them, yet see in what ways they are deluded away from the truth. Say, will you worship besides Allah something which has no power either to harm or benefit you? But Allah, He it is that hears and knows all things. Say, O people of the book, exceed not in your religion the bounds of what is proper, trespassing beyond the truth, nor follow the vain desires of people who went wrong in times gone by, who misled many and strayed themselves from the even way. Curses were pronounced on those among the children of Israel who rejected faith by the tongue of David and of Jesus, the son of Mary, because they disobeyed and persisted in excesses. Nor did they usually forbid one another the iniquities which they committed. Evil indeed were the deeds which they did. You see many of them turning in friendship to the unbelievers. Evil indeed are the works which their souls have sent forward before them, with the result that Allah's wrath is on them, and in torment will they abide. If only they had believed in Allah, in the Prophet, and in what has been revealed to him, never would they have taken them for friends and protectors, but most of them are rebellious wrongdoers. Strongest among men in enmity to the believers will you find the Jews and pagans, and nearest among them in love to the believers will you find those who say, "We are Christians," because amongst these are men devoted to learning, and men who have renounced the world, and they are not arrogant.
Historic background. Surah Al-Ma'idah. Ayah's revelation place. 120 Medina. Name. This surah takes its name from verse 112 in which the word Maida occurs. Like the names of many other surahs, this name has no special relation to the subject of the surah but has been used merely as a symbol to distinguish it from other surahs. Period of revelation. The theme of this surah indicates, and tradition supported, that it was revealed after the Treaty of Hudaybiyah at the end of 6 AH or in the beginning of 7 AH. That is why it deals with those problems that arose from this treaty with 1,400 Muslims went to Mecca in Zilqa'dah 6 AH to perform Umrah, but the Quraysh, spurred by their enmity, prevented him from its performance, though it was utterly against all the ancient religious traditions of Arabia. After a good deal of hard and harsh negotiations, a treaty was concluded at Hudaybiyah according to which it was agreed that he could perform Umrah the following year. That was a very appropriate occasion for teaching the Muslims the right way of performing a pilgrimage to Mecca with the true Islamic dignity, and enjoining that they should not prevent the disbelievers from performing pilgrimage to Mecca as a retaliation for their misbehavior. This was not difficult at all, as many disbelievers had to pass through Muslim territory on their way to Mecca. This is why the introductory verses deal with the things connected with pilgrimage to Mecca, and the same theme has been resumed in verses 101 to 104. The other topics of this surah also appear to belong to the same period. The continuity of the subject shows that most probably the whole of the surah was revealed as a single discourse at one and the same time. It is also possible that some of its verses were revealed at a later period and inserted in this surah at different places where they fitted in. But there appears to be not the least gap anywhere in the surah to show that it might have comprised two or more discourses. Occasion of revelation. This surah was revealed to suit the requirements of the changed conditions, which were now different from those prevailing at the time of the revelation of Al-Imran and An-Nisa. Then the shock of the setback at Uhud had made the very surroundings of Al-Madinah dangerous for the Muslims. But now Islam had become an invulnerable power, and the Islamic State had extended to Najd on the east, to the Red Sea on the west, to Syria on the north, and to Mecca on the south. This setback which the Muslims had suffered at Uhud had not broken their determination. It had rather spurred them to action. As a result of their continuous struggle and unparalleled sacrifices, the power of the surrounding clans, within a radius of 200 miles or so, had been broken. The Jewish menace which was always threatening Al-Madinah had been totally removed, and the Jews in the other parts of Hijaz had become tributaries of the state of Al-Madinah. The last effort of the Quraysh to suppress Islam had been thwarted in the Battle of the Ditch. After this, it had become quite obvious to the Arabs that no power could suppress the Islamic movement. Now Islam was not merely a creed which ruled over the minds and hearts of the people, but had also become a state which dominated over every aspect of the life of the people who lived within its boundaries. This had enabled the Muslims to live their lives without let or hindrance, in accordance with their beliefs. Another development had also taken place during this period. The Muslim civilization had developed in accordance with the principles of Islam and the Islamic viewpoint. This civilization was quite distinct from all other civilizations in all its details, and distinguished the Muslims clearly from the non-Muslims in their moral, social, and cultural behavior. Mosques had been built in all territories, prayer had been established, and imam, leader, for every habitation and clan had been appointed. The Islamic civil and criminal laws had been formulated in detail and were being enforced through the Islamic courts. New and reformed ways of trade and commerce had taken the place of the old ones. The Islamic laws of marriage and divorce, of the segregation of the sexes, of the punishment for adultery and calumny and the like had cast the social life of the Muslims in a special mold. Their social behavior, their conversation, their dress, their very mode of living, their culture, etc., had taken a definite shape of its own. As a result of all these changes, the non-Muslims could not expect that the Muslims would ever return to their former fold. Before the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, the Muslims were so engaged in their struggle with the non-Muslim Quraysh that they got no time to propagate their message. This hindrance was removed by what was apparently a defeat but in reality a victory at Hudaybiyah. This gave the Muslims not only peace in their own territory but also respite to spread their message in the surrounding territories. Accordingly, addressed letters to the rulers of Iran, Egypt, and the Roman Empire and the chiefs of Arabia, inviting them to Islam. At the same time, the missionaries of Islam spread among the clans and tribes and invited them to accept the divine way of Allah. These were the circumstances at the time when Al-Ma'idah was revealed. Topics. It deals with the following three main topics: commandments and instructions about the religious, cultural, and political life of the Muslims. In this connection, a code of ceremonial rules concerning the journey for Hajj has been prescribed, the observance of strict respect for the emblems of Allah has been enjoined, and any kind of obstruction or interference with the pilgrims to the Kaaba has been prohibited. Definite rules and regulations have been laid down for what is lawful and unlawful in the matter of food, and self-imposed foolish restrictions of the pre-Islamic age have been abolished. Permission has been given to take food with the people of the book and to marry their women. Rules and regulations for the performance of wudu, ablutions, and bath and purification and tayammum, ablutions with dust, have been prescribed. Punishment for rebellion, disturbance of peace and theft have been specified. Drinking and gambling have absolutely been made unlawful. Expiation for the breaking of oath has been laid down and a few more things have been added to the law of evidence. Admonition to the Muslims. Now that the Muslims had become a ruling body, it was feared that power might corrupt them. At this period of great trial, Allah had admonished them over and over again to stick to justice and to guard against the wrong behavior of their predecessors, the people of the book. They have been enjoined to remain steadfast to the covenant of obedience to Allah and His Messenger, and to observe strictly their commands and prohibitions in order to save themselves from the evil consequences which befell the Jews and the Christians who had violated them. They have been instructed to observe the dictates of the Holy Quran in the conduct of all their affairs and warned against the attitude of hypocrisy. Admonition to the Jews and the Christians. As the power of the Jews had been totally weakened and almost all their habitations in North Arabia had come under the rule of the Muslims, they have been warned again about their wrong attitude and invited to follow the right way. At the same time, a detailed invitation has also been extended to the Christians. The errors of their creeds have been clearly pointed out and they have been admonished to accept the guidance of incidentally, it may be noted that no direct invitation has been made to the Majusis and idolaters living in the adjoining countries, because there was no need for a separate address for them as their condition had already been covered by the addresses to the Mushrik Arabs. Subject: consolidation of the Islamic community. In continuation of the instructions about the consolidation of the Islamic community given in Surah An-Nisa, the Muslims have been directed to observe and fulfill all their obligations. Further regulations have been prescribed to train the Muslims for that purpose. They have also been particularly warned as rulers to guard against the corruption of power and directed to observe the covenant of the Quran. They have also been exhorted to learn lessons from the failings of their predecessors, the Jews and the Christians, who in their turn have been admonished to give up their wrong attitudes towards the right way and accept the guidance taught by Prophet Muhammad, may Allah bless him and grant him peace. Topics and their interconnection. The believers have been exhorted to fulfill scrupulously all of their obligations and follow the regulations prescribed by the divine law about food, sex, salat, justice, etc. 1-10 The Muslims have been warned to guard against the errors of their predecessors, they should follow the right path and avoid the bad example of the Jews and the Christians, who broke their covenants and went astray into evil ways. They, in their turn, have been admonished to give up their wrong ways and accept Islam. 11-26 The story of the two sons of Adam has been related to reproach the Jews for their plot to kill and his companions. V11 and EN30. The story has also been used to emphasize the sanctity of human life. 27-32 To achieve this object, punishments have been prescribed for those who create chaos in the Islamic State, and the believers have been urged to exert their utmost to establish the right way. The sanctity of property has also been emphasized. 33-40, and through him the Muslims, has been reassured that he should not mind the enmity, the evil designs and the machinations of the Jews, but continue exerting his utmost to establish the right way in accordance with the guidance of the Quran, for nothing better could be expected from those who had forsaken their own Torah. He should deal with the Christians likewise, for they, too, had forsaken their gospel. 41-50 In view of the degenerate moral condition of the Jews and the Christians, the believers have been warned not to make them their friends and confidants. Likewise they should be on their guard against the evil designs of the hypocrites, the disbelievers, and the like and should rely on the true believers alone. The people of the book have, in their turn been exhorted to give up their enmity and adopt the right attitude, for they cannot get salvation without this. 51-69 The theme of the corruptions of the Jews and Christians has been resumed. The Christians especially have been reproved for their errors in regard to the doctrine of Tawhid. At the same time they have been preferred to the hard-hearted Jews, for there are among them some who are more inclined towards the truth. 70-86 In this portion of the surah, further regulations about the lawful and the unlawful, in addition to those contained in verses 1-10, have been given. 87-108 At the end of the surah, the mention of the conversation that will take place between Allah and His prophets on the Day of Judgment, has been made for the benefit of the erring people to serve as a corrective to their creeds. The conversation with Prophet Christ has been cited as a specimen to warn particularly the Christians, who profess to believe in Him, and generally all those people who put false hopes in their prophets, etc. 109-119. Conclusion, O mankind! The sovereignty of the heavens and the earth belongs to Allah, therefore you should become His true servants and fear Him, for He has full powers over everything. 120.